There's another step of this process. After the House impeaches, they have to deliver the articles of impeachment to the Senate, and then the Senate does what it does. There's a trial, and then they have to vote whether to acquit or to convict. Let's go to Manu Raju on Capitol Hill for more on that. And Manu, so what's next? When will those articles be delivered to the Senate?
That's the big question here. Actually, I just tried to ask the Speaker of the House, Nancy Pelosi, when she would actually transmit the one article of impeachment over to the Senate that would begin the Senate, the trial process in the Senate. She did not answer questions. She would also not answer questions about her reaction to Senator Mitch McConnell and McConnell's plan to wait until after the Senate returns on January 19th, not bring the Senate back earlier before Donald Trump leaves office in order to have a tryout to push him out of office. And we just got a statement as we were coming on air here, guys, from Mitch McConnell. He essentially is explaining why he will wait. I'm just going to read it to you. So bear with me because we're getting it right now. Mitch McConnell is critical here to determine whether or not Donald Trump will get convicted in the United States Senate. He said the House of Representatives has voted to impeach. Has voted to impeach the president. The Senate process will now begin at our first regular meeting following receipt of the article from the House. So he says the Senate process will now begin at our first regular meeting following receipt of the article from the House. Regular meeting, meaning January 19th. Okay, he's given, now this is what he goes on to say, given the rules, procedures, and Senate precedents that govern presidential impeachment trials, there is simply no chance that a fair or serious trial that could conclude before President-elect Biden is sworn in next week. He says there's no chance a fair trial could happen before Biden is sworn in. He goes on to say the Senate has held three presidential impeachment trials. They've lasted 83 days, 37 days, and 21 days, respectively. So he said even if the Senate process were to begin this week and move promptly, no final verdict would be reached until after President Trump had left office. He goes on to say that this is not a decision that I am making. It is a fact that President-elect himself slated last week that his inauguration on January 20th is the quickest path for any change to the occupant of the presidency. He's pointing the finger back at Biden of sorts. He goes on to say, in light of this reality, I believe it would be best to serve our nation if Congress and the executive branch spend the next 7 days focused on the transition. And then he goes on to talk about how he's grateful for law enforcement through all this. What he does not say is what his position is. He said in an email to his colleagues today that he had not made a position yet. He said he wanted to listen to the arguments in the trial to decide whether or not to convict Donald Trump. So his position will be critical to determining whether or not there'll be 67 senators who would convict Donald Trump. But significant statement here saying no way, no how can there be a Senate trial before Donald Trump leaves office. That means Donald Trump is going to serve out his term. Now, if something changes or the president somehow decides to resign, which we're not expecting, McConnell here making clear any trial is going to begin in the Biden presidency, guys.
What's going to Phil Mattingly up on Capitol Hill is monitoring these truly historic developments for us. So, Phil, set the scene for us. Tell us what we're about to see.
Yeah, Wolf, just think of it this way. 1 week ago at this very moment, Capitol Police were still under siege, trying to push a mob outside of the United States Senate, of the United States House. Today, the U.S. House, 7 days later, has impeached President Trump for inciting an insurrection. 10 Republicans joining with 222 Democrats, leading to that impeachment, a historic second impeachment, the first time that has ever occurred in the country's history for a president. And what that will set forth over the course of the coming days will be the opportunity for the United States Senate to rule on how they view of what the president's actions were 1 week ago today. Now, what we're going to see over the course of the next 30 minutes or so is, as you noted, Speaker Pelosi will hold an engrossment of the article of impeachment. We still do not know when exactly that article will be walked over to the United States Senate. Even though the Senate's not currently in session, there is precedent for the House managers to walk the article over. That does not mean, however, a Senate trial will be starting anytime soon. In fact, Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, who will only be Majority Leader for a little bit more than a week, made clear no trial will begin until Joe Biden is inaugurated President of the United States. McConnell, however, did not rule out voting to convict President Trump. It's something that we reported on yesterday, first reported by the New York Times, that the leader, according to sources familiar with his thinking, believes the president did in fact commit impeachable offenses. In fact, I'm told by multiple sources that McConnell has been furious that before before the attack occurred, that Republicans were lining up with the president trying to overturn election results, even angrier in the wake of the attack, not just because of the attack itself, but also the lack of contrition from President Trump. So where McConnell lands on this, still very much an open question, but Wolf, it is incredibly noteworthy that McConnell is not rejecting this out of hand. Keep in mind, back in 2020, after House Democrats sent the articles of impeachment over to the Senate, Mitch McConnell was one of the president's biggest defenders, one of his most vocal and forceful defenders. Not this time around, and that has left Senate Republicans trying to figure out where this is all going to land. In fact, McConnell hadn't sent word to Republicans about where he stood on things until just a couple of hours ago, and several Republican aides that I've been talking to say their bosses are trying to figure out where this moment leads them. Obviously, everybody, not unlike in the House and the United States Senate, completely unnerved, unsettled, and outraged by what occurred a week ago, many of them placing the blame directly on President Trump. Whether that means at least 17 of them will join with all 50 Democrats to convict the president, that is still an open question. But we did get some sense of where the Republican Party stands today, and that is it is in the middle of a rupture. You had 10 Republicans join with Democrats. That is the most bipartisan impeachment vote in the history of the United States. However, 197 Republicans, even though they were in the House chamber or in the House complex when the attack occurred on January 6th, voted not to impeach President Trump. Many of them saying it was a waste of time, many of them calling it divisive as well. So, Wolf, it underscores the Republican Party is far from unified on this, and there are major, major questions about where this will land when it gets to the United States Senate. One thing we do know for a fact, President Trump has been impeached for a second time, the first time in the history of the United States.
And we're standing by to hear from Nancy Pelosi, the House Speaker. We'll have live coverage of her news conference. That's coming up soon. Phil, thank you very much. You know, John, if you look at the language, one article of impeachment, a significant article, but among other things, 232 members of the House of Representatives, including 10 Republicans, voted in favor of this sentence. President Trump gravely endangered the security of the United States and its institutions of government. That's a powerful indictment of a sitting president, even though he only has 7 days left in office.
It is stunning, just as we were stunned when we were in this studio 1 week ago, watching people wearing MAGA hats, carrying Trump banners, storming into that Capitol, breaking windows. Nancy Pelosi is going to speak moments from now, standing at the podium that we saw one of those rioters trying to steal. It's the very same podium. She's doing it for a reason, to send a signal here. And so on this defining day, the president of the United States has been impeached, and the charge is that he essentially cooperated, orchestrated, organized an attack on his own government. Think about that. I mean, think about that. We get caught up in this. There's so much happening. There are so many moving parts. This historic vote just happened. The president of the United States was impeached for inciting an attack on his government, on one of its monuments, the United States Capitol. He will fight this. He will protest this because of the timing of the Senate trial. His attorneys, whoever they end up being, will argue that you can't do it, that he's already gone, that it's moot. But judges have been impeached in the past, even after they have resigned and left. So there is some precedent for that. So we have another chapter of the Trump impeachment, the second Trump impeachment, to play out the Senate trial. Phil makes a point that I think everybody needs to consider and consider carefully. The door is wide open for Senate Republicans now. It was not when he was impeached the first time. It was very clear the Senate Republicans were not going to go along, and only Mitt Romney stood up and voted yes on one of the two counts. This is a different terrain. Mitch McConnell saying he is open-minded essentially guarantees there will be Republican yes votes. Maybe not his, but essentially guarantees there will be Republican yes votes, and the question is how many? Can they get to 17? Can they convict? It's somewhat moot. It's for the history books, not for actions. Trump will be gone by then, but then do they include, you know, prohibiting him from ever seeking office again? That is a big deal. Mitch McConnell would like that. Mitch McConnell would like the threat of Trump as a force on the ballot to be gone from Republican politics. But let's also, Wolf, there are so many things to talk about. How does it complicate the Biden presidency? What happens to the House Republicans now that they are so divided? Now we wait for the Senate chapter. We still don't know. Will this diminish Trump in the post-presidency? That's what the Republicans voting for it in the House and thinking about voting for it in the Senate want. They want a diminished, weakened, shrunken, shoved to the sidelines Donald Trump. Will it? Or will he try to make himself a martyr and a victim and to keep his supporters activated somehow? He doesn't have social media at his disposal anymore. So a defining moment, a defining day, a very important vote. Still a lot of questions.